Reno Medical Center is located in the heart of Reno and has provided quality health care to our community for over 45 years. We offer medical, dental, pediatrics, pharmacy, behavioral health therapy, x-ray, mammography, diabetes education, and on-site lab services. We accept most insurance plans and offer a sliding fee scale for qualifying patients. Make us your family's medical home and let us care for you. Reno Medical Center. Excellent healthcare right at home.
Western Auto in Raynell is the solution for all of your automotive repair needs. We carry snow blowers, wood splitters, propane heaters, and a full line of Husqvarna saws, bars, and chains. And most importantly, service after the sale. We also carry Whirlpool washers and dryers, freezers, refrigerators, and hot water heaters. We have enjoyed serving our community for 48 years and support our Greenbrier West Cavaliers.
The next time you find yourself stuck, broken down, or stranded, call Steve's Towing. Serving eastern and western Greenbrier counties and surrounding areas, he won't charge an arm and a leg. All he wants is a tow. Providing rollback service for light and medium duty vehicles, as well as lockout service and jump starts. Call 304-661-5255. Steve Fields, owner and operator.
Hello, everybody. Welcome in a huge game of basketball tonight in Linside. It is the 8-2, number 3, James Monroe Mavericks set to host the 6-4, number 10, Greenbrier West Cavaliers in what may be the premier single-A matchup in the state tonight. And we're going to have it all for you right here. JV is getting ready to see their clock tick down in a tight game right now. 49-50, James Monroe leads in the JV contest. So as soon as it gets done, we will be getting into warm-ups and then into action. So don't go anywhere. We're going to be right here on Greenbrier Valley Channel. We'll see you for the tip.
already on?
All right, we're here with Mavericks head coach Matt Savage. He's getting ready for this big one here tonight. Matt, how you doing?
I'm doing great, man. Excited for tonight.
That's great. Hey, you know, a lot of people might not have seen a lot of this new look Mavericks team so far this year. They had a lot of success. What do you tell them about the team a little bit?
You know, it's different than what they've seen. And it's not necessarily bad or it's not necessarily good. It's just going to be different than what you're used to. But the one thing that's constant for us is you're still going to see him get after it on the defensive end.
Yeah, you know, we've talked to a couple of players in the games we've had before. One thing that keeps coming up is the culture here. You know, you lose the team that, well, four starters from the team you had last year had a couple runs of state championships, and you have a newer team, but you still continue that winning tradition. So tell me about that culture and what you instill in these guys from freshmen as they come up all the way through.
Yeah, you know, and it's exactly what you said. The last couple of years have started to build that culture. And, you know, it actually started 4 years ago. And we actually didn't have a very good season that season. We were 8-15. But that's when the culture started to build. The mindset started, and, you know, it's carried over into these guys, and now the seniors are leading it for the younger ones. And that's what it takes. You got to have your older ones lead it for the younger ones. And so their mindset is, you know, we can create our own legacy too. And that's what they're trying to do.
Yeah, you know, that's exactly what Eli Allen told us last year, that it was that year that really started building things. Yeah. Even though it wasn't successful, it really led into what they were able to do later. Speaking of him, you know, he was a big leader for the team. Who's taken over that spot this year? Who's really stepped up in practice as this leader?
You know, I'll say Cooper and Layton, both of them. Cooper and Layton have really stepped up, and it's more on the side of watch me and do what I do. It's not necessarily, you know, all the talk. If somebody's not doing that, then obviously they jump them to get it going. But, you know, they lead by example right now, and, you know, that's what it's going to take.
Speaking of that, tonight you've got a big matchup here with Greenbrier West, and it's always a good game. Doesn't matter what the sport, what time of year. When these two teams get together, it's always going to be a show, gets a lot of interest. So what do you see tonight in this matchup?
Oh, you're going to see more of the same. And, you know, West is having a good year. We're having a pretty good year, and, you know, it's going to be fun. And, you know, it's became a fun rivalry for us, and, you know, not necessarily a bad rivalry. You know, it's a fun rivalry. And so I'm looking forward to it, and I know the boys are too.
Yeah, you know, we were over here getting ready to come on the court. I saw you joking around with some of the Greenbrier West players. It's a good relationship these groups have together.
Oh, 100%. You know, I know a few of them where I teach up at East. You know, I got to know a few of them. And then, of course, McClung, I feel like he's been there forever. Of course, it's been his brother, too. But you know, this group of West boys, they're a good group of boys, you know. And I've enjoyed competing with them. And hopefully tonight it's going to be another competitive one.
Yeah, we certainly hope so. We're going to be here to see it. And best of luck tonight, Coach.
Appreciate it. Thank you.
Thank you. All right, we're down here now with Greenbrier West head coach Robertson. Coach, how you doing?
Doing good, sir. Thank you.
How's you know, a lot of people might not have a great feel for what your team's bringing in here tonight. You want to tell us a little bit about them?
Yeah, we've been up and down a little bit. We played a pretty challenging schedule, lost a couple tough games to good teams, beat some teams that people might say we should beat. But I think we've got a little better the last couple weeks, and It's a good night for us to see where we're at.
Hey, you know, your school's had a lot of success, not just in basketball, but other sports throughout the past few years. Tell me about the culture you put in with your team. We talked to a little bit of Coach Savage about culture here. Tell us about the culture of Greenbrier West that you want to instill.
Well, you know, we had a great football season. Some of these kids played football. I think they expect to win, and that's, you know, I think James Monroe has the same thing. When you have kids that expect to win, it makes it easier to win. And that's one thing with our younger guys that didn't have a lot of success in the middle school. Sometimes it's trying to teach them how to win. But, you know, you get in a game like this, it's a rivalry game. I don't know how much records matter a lot of times. It's just kids want to win and get after it. So hopefully we're here to show up tonight.
Yeah, I got to talk a little bit of the rivalry with Coach Savage earlier. He talked about it being a fun rivalry where these guys like to get there to compete, not necessarily, I don't know how to put it otherwise than that, but a good rivalry, if you would say. So yeah. What are your thoughts on that?
Well, they've had our number the last couple of years, but they've had everybody's number too. It's not just been us. They lost a lot. You know, we play them, so we knew they had a lot of talent coming back. I'm not surprised that they're as good and ranked as high as they are again. It's not just a testament to Coach Savage. It's also to their middle school coaches and the development they have in their program. But I think we're getting better, too, and we know this is the kind of team we need to figure out how to beat. So we'll find out tonight where we're at.
Yeah, certainly a big opportunity. What do you see coming into this game in particular? How have you been able to prepare?
Well, we did get a true practice yesterday just to work on James Monroe. With snow days and our football season backing games up, we've had several games where we haven't had that opportunity. But we did get to prep for them a little bit yesterday. They're kind of a unique group of athletes, and it's going to be a challenge for us for sure. But hopefully we got some things ready to let us be successful tonight.
Coach, good luck to you tonight, everybody. A lot of eyes around the state going to be on this game for single-A basketball, but good luck to you.
Absolutely. Thank you, sir.
Thank you. Appreciate it. Good luck, Coach.
Thank you.
best. Oh, there I am. Damn.
Lady Mavericks basketball player Leah Hill with the national anthem. And we're going to get the starting lineup coming. It's going to be number 2, Tanner Hagee. Number 10, Braden McClung.
Number
22,
Isaac
Agee.
Number
24,
Chris Davis.
Number
33, Colton Dunbar.
And number 33, Colton Dunbar. That is your Greenbrier West Cavaliers starting lineup, and the homestanding Mavericks will be next.
And now, starting lineup for the Mavericks, 6 foot junior, wearing number 1, Layton Doughty.
Layton Doughty, first off the bench.
6 foot senior, wearing number 10, Cooper Ridgeway.
Number 10, the senior, Cooper Ridgeway. Sophomore Ryan Mann.
6'3 senior, wearing number 23, Ryan Cole.
Senior Ryan Cole has been a big part of this team to this point of the year. And the center, Brady Baker, will be the last off the bench. And that is your starting lineup for both teams. It's Boomer Yancey here with Jamie Coulter. We're going to have you wall-to-wall action here tonight. And we're just about ready to get into it. Jamie, how you doing?
Doing good. Nice night outside, nice night inside. Looking at West there, we're all familiar with what James Rose is going to put on the floor. A couple of decent-sized players there, one coming in here, Colton Dunbar, 6'4", 200 pounds, and he's going to be jumping. I was watching him during the warm-ups. He has a jump shot more as well as what I would anticipate strong inside play.
And it's going to be Dunbar and Cole in the center circle. Ball's in the air, and we're off. Tip back is going to be controlled by West. Hagee has it onto the left side, guarded there by Mann. Calling for some action, gets it over to Agee. Agee's going to get it back to Hagee. Jump shot up and good from the left baseline. They're going to work the ball to their guard, Dowdy. And he comes back to Ridgeway. Ridgeway to Dowdy. Dowdy works into man on the wing. Looking inside. Now he's going to come all the way back to the top to Dowdy. Tough pass, but he brings it down. Gets it to Ridgeway. Ridgeway feeds into man. Bounces over to Cole. Cole in the corner. All the way across to Dowdy. Back to the top. That is Ridgeway. Now into Cole. Cole turns, gets a shot up, and the Mavericks answer 2-2.
I tell you, that extra pass means the world. Tell West to scout this James Monroe team. They know that they're going to flash people up to the free throw line to key their offense off of, and they denied that pass.
Dunbar tries to get a pass inside to Davis, but it's batted around. Now Davis is able to recover. Gets it to Hagee. Hagee stops, gives up his dribble. Now comes to the side of McClung. McClung works on the left side, gets baseline, gets his man in the air, and man is going to foul him on the way down. Shot doesn't go, but it'll be two shots coming for Braden McClung.
Yeah, man's having a hard time there. He's having to switch off and wound up switching off and staying on the ball. Just two really quick, agile West players there, and he bought the whole meal there with a head and shoulders fake.
Shot up off the front of the rim, doesn't get it to go. I had a chance to interview both coaches before the game started, and one thing Coach Savage mentioned was some of the players on this team, Braden McClung being one who's been here a long time. Think about this. Braden McClung was on the team that came in here and beat James Monroe in that regional final that kept him from going to a state tournament 4 years ago. And
yeah,
his brother was
pressure
there before that. And Baker muscles his way in but can't get the shot to go, but a tough rebound by Dowdy. Gets it in to Baker. Baker looking for some help. Finds Dowdy on the wing. Going to come back to Ridgeway. Works into the corner. Back to the top to Dowdy. Dowdy finds Ridgeway on the ring. Wing trying to direct traffic. Gets to Cole. Thought about that three, but closed out quickly by Agee. Said he gets it back to Ridgeway. Ridgeway's going to drive in. Extra steps, and they're going to call the travel into the lane.
Yeah, that whole possession, I was watching Baker and Dunbar. They're just going at it hammer and tooth down there.
It's always a good game when these teams get together. It doesn't matter if it's basketball or badminton. You're going to have a contest. And there's a foul on Ridgeway.
Yeah, I was speaking to a colleague of mine who is from the Rainale area, and we were remarking about it. And it doesn't matter. The teams, basketball, football, doesn't matter. Both teams seem to have good teams at the same year and have down years at the same time. And neither one of us can determine why this has become such a rivalry.
McClung feeds the ball to Dunbar. Now get it back to Hagee. Hagee's guarded by a man. Comes back to the side to McClung. McClung gets a screen. Loses handle on the ball, but is able to get it back. He's going to be guarded well away from the basket by Ridgeway. Now works his way in. Drives. Shot up. Off glass. Good. Took it all the way. 5-2 lead for the Cavaliers here early.
Yeah, you can do that by just 33 set, just a stationary screen down there in the paint, was in there for about 17 seconds, but that's what permitted that to happen.
And a drive by Ridgeway. He lays it in to answer, and he's fouled. That'll send him to the line with a chance to tie this game. I think it's going to go against McClung.
It'd be good to get him in foul trouble early. At least see Cooper, you saw last game I did against
actually, yeah, it's going to be against Chris Davis.
Yeah, numbers up there now. Putting that body between the defender and the ball.
And he got it. That will tie things. Ball into the wing goes to Agee. He's going to work against a double team. Feeds inside to Dunbar. And another foul. Is that against Mann? That'll be his second. So that'd be good news for the Cavaliers. Starting to get a couple of Mavericks in early foul trouble, and it is.
Momentary lapse of reason there.
And Will Boggess is going to be quick off the bench to take man out.
He was out of defensive position. I think he knew it and just out of frustration reached in and picked up the foul. Really didn't need to because the player was being defended.
Oh, and Hagee took a little jab step there as he started his drive and an extra one, and they're going to call that. 5-5 and a turnover. We'll give the ball back to James Monroe with 5 minutes to play in the first quarter, and Ridgeway controls. Going to be guarded well away by Dunbar. Going to pick him up right at half court. Drives in, layup too strong. A big rebound by Brady Baker. Spins in the lane, shot up, scores. and a foul, and you can see the excitement. This game means a lot to both these teams. Brady Baker exploded out of that after the shot. That'll be the first foul on McClung. And the free throw too strong. Rebound batted around and brought down by McClung. McClung gives a hesitation. Spins in the lane. Shot up and good.
Talk about Ridgeway body control. There's
answer for answer right there.
That impressive little bit of offensive play there.
August with the ball drives. Sloth layup in front and got it. That's a tough shot to make when you're driving straight in. You don't have the backboard to use.
And you're right-handed. And he did. He put that ball up with his right hand.
Two-point lead now for the Mavericks on the Will Bogus shot. Shot up from Hagee. Leaves it short. Rebound's going to be brought out by Will Bogus. Short into this game, but he is already making a big impact in just a few possessions that he's been here. Now Ridgeway's going to work into the lane. Gives up his dribble. Stops. Jump shot. Short. Rebound. Cleared out by Dunbar. Going to work the ball to A.G. and now back to McClung.
Yeah, I think Cooper's a little bit surprised to be left alone there.
And Chris Davis. Chris Davis gets it to Hagee in the corner. Trapped there and gets it back into Davis. And a lot of contact underneath. No foul. It's safe from going out of bounds, but it ends up in the hands of Cole. He hands to Ridgeway, and now they're going to come back to Cole. He's thinking about that three from long range. Haven't seen him put up a shot yet, but he's itching to. And now he's just going to go back to Ridgeway.
Yeah, and he definitely does have that capability.
Ridgeway's going to drive in, left open there, but the lane closed down, and it's just enough to stop it. A rebound put back up. Is that Cole that got in there and had that rebound?
Yeah, sure was.
It was, I believe, Isaac Agee who cut off Ridgeway and forced that miss, but nobody's able to box out. Ryan Cole coming from the left side.
Cole, with his length, was able to get that rebound out of position.
McClung with the jumper, leaves it short, and rebound batted around, brought down by Cole. Cole to Ridgeway, long pass up to Dowdy. Dowdy comes back to Ridgeway, and he'll be guarded there at the top of the key.
There's a defensive mismatch, offensive mismatch there. Cooper's unable to take
it. And a feed into Baker, who cut off the pick. It said a pick and roll, and he got through it, but his defender was Dunbar. Didn't really bite on it, went with him, but they just fit that in the needle. 13-7 now. Mavericks lead with 2.5 minutes to play in the first.
As Brady cut there, he's able to get that perfect angle.
McClung to Hagee. Three on the way from Hagee. He just leaves it long. Some contact underneath. A couple players on the floor. It's both tens. It's Ridgeway and McClung. And Dowdy comes out with it. Ball tipped away. Saved by Boggs, but lost out of bounds. He had it for a second and couldn't keep the handle. So it'll be 13-7, and Cavaliers will control.
Watch West set up a double pick and try to rub the defender off whenever there's three people up there. They've done it twice, not successful each time on the near to the James Ray side of the bench up next to the free throw line. And there it was, well, almost again.
A.G. with the ball. He's going to drive now, gets it back out to McClung. McClung with a shot and in. McClung's made a couple of tough shots here early, and it makes it a four-point game, 13-9. Boggs drives. Tries to step around. He's going to lose the ball out of bounds.
It was off of number 30.
Yeah, they're going to say last touch by Bogus. And it's going to head back to the Cavaliers.
See, watch them there, 22 and 30. See if they do it this time. No, they're not going to. Going to
hand off to A.G. He comes back to the top. Ball swiped away, but they get it back out to Dixon. Dixon just fresh into this game. And a shot put up by A.G., and they're going to say lost it out of bounds.
He tried to kind of underhand finger roll that thing, and it just rolled right off the.
They're going to have Tanner Hagee coming back into this game. He's going to relieve Isaac A.G. And we're back to action. 1:15 to play in the first. Ridgeway with the ball. He's cut off there by Dunbar. Dunbar's been on Ridgeway the entire night. They're really sticking him on him every time they're on offense. A feed to Baker, and they get it back to Ridgeway, and there's a foul. That's going to go against, I believe it's going to be McClung.
Yeah, they were setting up that give and go as Brady pulled himself farther and farther out of the paint there to open up that.
So foul trouble starting to stack up a little bit here in the first. Ryan Mann on the bench with two fouls, and now Braden McClung has picked up his second. A three in the air from Dunbar doesn't go. Rebound taken out by Dixon. Dixon's going to find Tanner Hagee, and he'll advance the ball over midcourt to the left side. Comes up to McClung. McClung has been a big part of this offense so far. If he gets an open shot, he's going to drive in. Gets a hard shot up. It's going to be fouled. That is Ryan Cole, his first, and McClung will head to the line.
Yeah, speaking of foul trouble, Ryan Mann is probably one of the most hectic defenders on his team. That's probably the strongest part of his game, his defense. And you hate to see him over there with 2-1
and
riding the pine this early.
First shot misses, and with that, Dunbar is going to come out of the game, and Isaac Agee back on. So Cavaliers are cycling through their starting lineup right now, getting everybody some air. They want fresh legs throughout this entire game. Ridgeway gets the ball back to the top of the key. It's been in the hands of Dowdy. Dowdy finds Will Baugus to the left side, looking to feed all the way across to Cole. Cole comes back to Baugus, and just too tall. He goes up and just try to knock it down, but he knocks it down right onto the line.
Yeah, those passes are dangerous, especially whenever you've got a couple of people, 6'2 and 6'4 up there, that can get in the way of the passing lane and makes you throw the ball way too high for anybody to handle.
Yeah, I think I might have said that Isaac Agee came in a minute ago. Actually, it was Chris Davis who came in. Agee just come in to relieve McClung with those two fouls. Hagee has the ball, and he loses it but gets it back, guarded by Ridgeway. Feed inside. That's to Davis. He's double-teamed, and time's going to expire before they can get a shot up. So, tight game, just kind of what we expected out of these two teams. Always getting after each other. And
a lot of defense.
13-9. So we're going to take a quick break and be back for the second quarter. It's going to be good. Don't go anywhere. Okay, folks, break's over. We're back. Inbound to Will Baugus. He's still in the game. Ryan Mann has those two fouls. Him and Braden McClung both in foul trouble early with the two, and they're both on their benches. Will Baugus in some trouble here as he tries to work the ball into Brady Baker. Gets it, spins, covered up. Now back to Baugus. Baugus with a jab step, loses his dribble, heads back to Dowdy. Dowdy finds Ridgeway. Ridgeway all the way back across to Baugus. He's going to push up a three from the left wing and got it. Will Baugus has been a big impact for the Mavericks since he came in off the bench. I believe he's got 5 points.
Yeah, he certainly has. Lots of you've seen come off the bench and primarily be a ball handler. You don't see much offense out of him.
It's going to be out of bounds. It's the last touch, I believe, was Will Baugus. And Dixon's going to come out of the game.
McClung's back in.
Yeah, it looks
you're
like.
You're not going to set him very long.
No, I don't think you can set Braden McClung very long at all. And he gets a three up immediately and almost cashes in on it, but Dunbar gets the rebound. It's loose on the floor, and it's Baugus who comes away with it. But as he dives, he lands on the inline, and it's going to head right back to the Cavaliers.
I'm not sure that maybe should have been a jump ball right before that happened, but we complain about the refs being too quick on the jump ball and too slow. So. And there wasn't even really a head and shoulder fake there that got to change the road player well up in the air and just created an easy off our defensive foul.
Yeah, who? Okay, that was on Will Baugus, that foul.
Baugus, yeah.
And the shot doesn't go. It's going to be rebounded by Doughty. He gets it over to Ryan Cole, comes back to Doughty. And now Will Baugus here on the right side. They've done a good job of denying Ryan Cole a lot of looks so far. Only points coming off that putback rebound he had. They find Doughty in the lane, shot up in front, and just leaves it a little bit short. Brought out by Dunbar on a strong rebound. He tries to find Isaac Agee and just loses it a little bit. He was coming out kind of
out of control and sort of falling. Yeah.
Yeah. He had to step over. Might have been Leighton Doughty, and kind of threw off the pass, ended up out of bounds. They get it over to Doughty now. Back to the top to Baugus. Swing it over to Cole. He's going to put up that three now. It's a little strong off the back of the rim, and rebound taken out by Agee. Agee good in a hurry. He's going to run down, spins in the lane, and a shot up. Oh, what a move by Isaac Agee.
Yeah, you can't defend that. There's two James Road players down there under the basket, and there's not much you can do with that.
They work the ball over to Baugus now. He dribbles in and loses it. It's going to be taken away by Braden McClung. He's up. Will Baugus has a chance, but nobody going to stop McClung and instead fouls him. That is an ill-advised move.
Yeah.
That's going to be the second foul on Baugus, and it's going to send Braden McClung to the line with a chance for a three-point play.
Just run down there really hard, act like you're going to take his legs out and stop.
Shot on the way. Looks good.
If you are going to commit that foul, commit it before the man puts the ball up in the air. At least have some impact on it. Don't foul him after the shot.
So that cuts it down to a two-point game after the Mavericks had begun to pull away. And it's going to put Will Baugus in the same foul trouble that Ryan Mann's in. And with that, we're going to have – looks like Bannon Goodman's going to get ready to check in. Fed to Cole on the wing. He gets a man in the air. He's going to be fouled. They're going to say before the shot. And it'll be an inbound coming for James Monroe.
Is that foul going to be on? Well,
that's going to be the third on Braden McClung. Oh, wow.
Yeah, he was there. I just didn't know if they were going to call him for it or someone else.
Yeah, it's a tough position. Cole is driving in from the left wing down the baseline, and he – you know, you've got to get in there and try to do something with him. And he just gets his man in the air and draws the foul. But not the what they wanted to happen there was to get Braden McClung. Now we've got – now it's showing two fouls on the board for him. Not sure what's changed. They went back and have taken that down to two fouls. See if – I don't think they've assigned it to anybody else. Oh, no, they have. Okay, they have reassigned that foul to Chris Davis. So that is about the best news you could look for.
If you're West,
if you're
absolutely
the Cavaliers, is that Braden McClung still only has two fouls. And that was going to be a big storyline in this game going forward if he had picked that one up.
I tell you who is really happy about that timeout is Brady Baker because he was getting gassed.
Gets the ball into Ridgeway. Still guarded closely. And they've actually taken Dunbar off of Ridgeway now. They have Chris Davis over there. And Ridgeway with the ball is going to work in underneath. Gets a shot up. Can't get it to go. Tough shot, but it's rebound knocked away by Dunbar. It ends up in the hands of McClung. Stops, puts up a jump shot off the back of the rim. Out of bounds. Last touch.
Oh,
Ryan Cole.
Not so sure about that.
Be an inbound for the Cavaliers. They're going to have an opportunity to tie this game on this possession, even take a lead. Instead, they lose the ball out, and it's Ryan Cole who comes away with it. Ball up to Ridgeway. He's going to drive into the lane, and it's poked away. Dunbar got his hand in there and just knocked it back. Goes to McClung. McClung finds Agee, and now back to McClung. Three in the air. Got it, and the Cavaliers take the lead.
Yeah, James Rowe needs to slow and get 2 points here. Just take their time. There's no shot clock. There you go.
It's to Ridgeway. Tries to get into Baker. It's knocked away. They go back out to Cole. Cole comes to the top of the key. Goes to Doughty. Now it's back to Doughty. Into Baker. Baker spins hook shot up and can't get that one to go. Just left it on the back of the rim.
Well, you can't complain about them. They ran their offense and got a beautiful shot. Just weren't able to convert.
Heggie comes to McClung, three in the air. That one's off the back of the rim. No, that would have been a big shot for the Cavaliers. And a cut to Bannon Goodman, and he puts it up hard. Can't get it to go. A lot of contact on the rebound. It puts – who is that? Is that McClung took the worst end of that from Brady
Baker.
Yeah,
McClung and Baker were tied up there just for a second as though it was going to be a jump ball. And Brady said, here, I'll take that. That's mine.
Yeah, McClung ended up on the floor. And
no contact between them. It was just a tied-up ball. And
through all that, ends up with a Ryan Cole free throw opportunity, and he gets the first one. It's going to tie this game up.
Glad to see James Rowe pass two possessions. They've slowed it down. They've taken their time, ran their offense. They got one good shot, look, that didn't drop, and then this one here, they got a – 2 points from the free throw stripe there, so that's a whole lot better than one pass and shoot.
We've got Levi Ramsey, who has just checked into this game. He has come in for Colton Dunbar.
Yeah.
And was that Chris Davis hit that shot from the wing, and it's going to put the Cavaliers up 19-18. Bannon Goodman with the ball on the right wing comes to Ridgeway. Now to Dowdy all the way across to Cole. Cole thought about the shot, says he's going to feed into Baker. Baker turns in the lane, finds Bannon Goodman, three on the way, and just a little strong there. Rebound fought for, and it's going to end up being brought out by Agee.
Again, it's a possession area you can't really complain about.
And Heggie gets a shot up, leaves that off the front of the rim, and it's tipped away by Brady Baker, ends up in the hands of Bannon Goodman, and now it's up to Dowdy. Dowdy all the way back to top to Cole. Straightaway three in the air. That one rolls out.
He just can't buy one tonight.
McClung drives in, stops, jump shot up and good. He's hit that shot all night.
Yeah, other than foul him, you know, realistically, what are you going to do?
18-21 now, a three-point lead for the Cavaliers as Ridgeway drives in. That ball's knocked away, and they're going to say last touched by the Cavaliers. I don't think that they agreed with that one.
No, the West bench down there right along the baseline there wasn't happy with that call at all. It is what it is.
And pass goes out to Goodman, almost taken away, but now they're going to get over to Dowdy in the corner.
They need to watch these cross-court passes. They're going to get bitten there sooner or later.
Brady McClung almost got his hand on that one just a second ago, and it's Ridgeway going to get over to Cole, three in the air, and goes over top of everything on that. So Ryan Cole having trouble finding that three-point range tonight. Usually he's pretty good from there. Tanner Hagee's going to drive it. He's going to get the jump shot up mid-range, in and out. He's having a little bit of trouble finding the range on that shot as well.
He was well defended on that shot.
Pass comes all the way back up the top to Dowdy. Gets it back over to Ridgeway. Just lobs a pass into Baker. Baker back to the top to Ridgeway. Comes to Dowdy into the corner to Cole. Cole guarded there by Colton Dunbar.
Look how far they pulled the defense out. Now's the time to flash over to the free throw line.
They get it into Baker. Baker's going to spin. Gets that little over-the-head hook shot up. And a rebound brought down over the top by Ryan Cole. Can't get it. Gets his own rebound and then gets it. He went right over. I didn't catch exactly which Cavalier that was, but he went over to the top of somebody and just high-pointed that ball. And offensive foul. Is that going to go?
I think it's going to go with Dunbar. 33.
Yeah, he set the screen. I think they're going to call a trip.
He started to motion to charge, but I looked away to see if I could see any reaction from West players. It is 33.
Yeah, first foul on Colton Dunbar. Get it into Ryan Cole, over to Goodman. Three in the air from the left wing, leaves it short. Long rebound comes out to Agee. Agee's going to be in a hurry, driving down the lane, gets a shot up and just can't finish, but it's in the hands of McClung, and he can. And that'll make it 23-20. Cavaliers lead, just a minute and 15 seconds to play in the first half. Ridgeway comes all the way across to Cole. Cole guarded tightly by Dunbar. Gets it back out to Dowdy, and they'll reset the offense from the top. Dowdy steps up, feeds a pass into Baker. Baker with a pass to a cutting Bannon Goodman, and he can't get that shot to go from underneath. Rebound brought out by Dunbar.
See, James Regis is having terrible troubles on offense, and they're getting good shots.
And
for the most part.
Spin move by McClung, and he gets that to go, working against Ryan Cole, and we'll get a timeout. And the Cavalier bench erupts as they have taken out a five-point lead with 44 seconds to play in the first half.
And they're the ones that called the timeout here. So maybe a 30-second timeout.
A pretty exciting play right there. Maybe you want to take that timeout just to make sure your guys are calm for this last 45 seconds of defense.
If I was judging for that last possession, because you can't really complain about the shot they got, a minute and 15 seconds, I would play it as though that were my last shot of the half and run it, you know, take them a shot after about 30 seconds. I passed up a couple open opportunities, especially as bad a luck, and that's all you can really call it, bad luck, that they've been having, not getting really high percentage shots to drop. When you're not doing that, you certainly don't need to be taking no three-pointers. If you can't get one to drop from 18 inches, you know, outside the arc, it's... West getting a little late coming back into, I think they were wanting to set a press off of that.
Yeah, and they almost get the ball away from Ridgeway, but he's able to work it back to Dowdy. Comes to Dowdy again. Dowdy's going to push up the three from the left side. And a rebound out of bounds, and they'll say last touch was Dunbar.
Yeah, I know that was an open three. Leighton had an opportunity that he took there, but that's just.
And they have Ryan Cole open. And instead, they're going to come back over to Ridgeway. And they find Dowdy in the corner, 25 seconds, still a lot of time. And out of Dowdy, inside to Baker. Baker's going to work against McClung. Shot up, rolls around, down and in. Just ripped away by Bannon Goodman, and a foul. And the foul, is that going to go? Oh, I think it's going to go against Colton Dunbar. Yeah, it'll be his second.
Yeah, a little bit of frustration is having that ball stripped, and that is good that he's, at least for the end of the half, has picked up his second foul. He's picked up two pretty quickly. I don't know if it's
That's Randy Keener who just came into this. We got a good look at him in the JV game. That was an exciting thing. Bannon Goodman with a three in the air. Got it, and a foul. Oh, wow. Bannon Goodman's going to have the opportunity for a rare four-point play. And that's the cardinal sin of basketball. You never foul the three-point shooter.
No, especially when they're doing as badly as James Rose has been doing from beyond the arc this game. You know, shoot, let them take it all day long.
And that's just the first foul on Tanner Heggie.
The percentages are well in your favor that they're not going to drop it, even though he did here.
Shot up from Goodman and got it. 11 seconds to play.
Just like that, it's a one-point game.
Cavaliers have time to get down the court
and
get a shot up.
Stay back, for God's sake, don't foul.
And Heggie drives in, gets the shot up. 2 seconds remain. Pass in. Long shot. And that won't go. But after a half, it's going to be a three-point lead for the Cavaliers. And they're excited.
James Rose got – they should – even though they let that lead get away from them, they should not be shell-shocked right now. They should be pretty happy that they're going in only three down.
Yeah, it was a five-point game just a couple seconds ago. So a three-point game to head in. We're going to take a break. We'll be back here in a few minutes. We'll have some stats, and we'll preview this second half. Guys, great game here in Linside. Do not go anywhere.
Reynell Medical Center is located in the heart of Reynell and has provided quality health care to our community for over 45 years. We offer medical, dental, pediatrics, pharmacy, behavioral health therapy, x-ray, mammography, diabetes education, and on-site lab services. We accept most insurance plans and offer a sliding fee scale for qualifying patients. Make us your family's medical home and let us care for you. Reynell Medical Center. Excellent health care. Right at home.
Western Auto in Reynell is the solution for all of your automotive repair needs. We carry snow blowers, wood splitters, propane heaters, and a full line of Husqvarna saws, bars, and chains. And most importantly, service after the sale. We also carry Whirlpool washers and dryers, freezers, refrigerators, and hot water heaters. We have enjoyed serving our community for 48 years and support our Greenbrier West Cavaliers.
The next time you find yourself stuck, broken down, or stranded, call Steve's Towing. Serving eastern and western Greenbrier counties and surrounding areas, he won't charge an arm and a leg. All he wants is a tow, providing rollback service for light and medium-duty vehicles, as well as lockout service and jump starts. Call 304-661-5255. Steve Fields, owner and operator.
Is it in good?
No, it's not.
You're in four?
Three. There it goes. It wasn't in. Yeah, it's working. We're good.
Have it there in case.
All right, folks, back to action quick. Get a look through that first half here in just a second. Well, we are off. Cavaliers with a three-point lead, and it is Dowdy who controls the ball for James Monroe. Funnels it to Ridgeway. Ridgeway drives in, loses a dribble. Now in the lane, turns, shot up. That's blocked. I think it was Braden McClung who got a piece of that one. Now A.G. with the ball comes back to the top to McClung. McClung goes to A.G. A.G. drives, works, and that's a pass inside, and he's able to save it as it goes back out of bounds. It was blocked up. I'm not sure it was coming off of a James Monroe player anyway, but he's able to save it, gets it over to McClung, gets a shot up, can't get that one to go. Good defense underneath. I believe it was Brady Baker who misdirected that shot. And now it'll be Dowdy. Gets a pass into a cutting Ridgeway, and Ridgeway scores from underneath. We'll cut this back to a one-point game. Look through that first half. Scoring for James Monroe. Spread out leading it is Ryan Cole, who has 8 points. 3 points for Goodman. Or no, 4 points for Goodman on that four-point play he got. And a turnover. That ball stolen on the pass by Ridgeway. Ridgeway goes to Dowdy. Dowdy's going to drive in, shot up, and scores. And with that, the Mavericks have taken the lead back, 28-27.
The offense and the defense, you've seen James Rowe, is all halftime adjustments made by coaching staff back there. There's several different things they've been doing differently.
McClung, another shot up, and he can't get that one to go. Rebound brought down by Baker. He gets out to Ryan Mann. This is Ryan Mann's first minutes back in this game since early in the first quarter when he got those two fouls. A three in the air from Cole, and just long. Rebound brought out by Dunbar. Hagee controls. He's going to drive in. Gets a pass over to Agee. Agee guarded in the wing by Ridgeway. Now they're going to work out to Hagee and come back to Agee. Into Hagee again. Hagee with a two-pointer up from the baseline. In and out. Rebound brought out. Ooh.
It'll be an offensive. I mean, I'm sorry. It'll be a foul on 33. It's going to be his third.
That's third foul on Colton Dunbar, and it comes just a couple minutes into this third quarter and about 90 feet away from the basket.
Yeah, it seemed like just kind of a mistake there in trying to grab that ball.
Yeah, Ryan Mann had the ball, and he was going for it, and they kind of made contact, but they called the foul. Let's go through this real quick. Will Baugus came away with 5 points in that first half. Cooper Ridgeway with three. Bannon Goodman had those four we talked about earlier. You go and you look at West, scoring's like this. 4 points for Tanner Hagee, two for A.G., two for Davis, 19 for Braden McClump.
As they got the ball down low there to Brady Baker, a little back and forth action there.
And that is the third foul on Chris Davis, so foul trouble starting to add up here for the Cavaliers.
Yeah, as he picked up, the shot was no good, obviously, but
misses the first. Cavaliers have a pretty deep bench. We've seen them go to it already, but they don't want to start losing any of these starters.
The field goal percentage of West in the beginning moments of this second half is something akin to James and Rose free field goal percentage in the latter part of the first half. Just can't buy a basket.
Got that one to go. Pass works up to Davis. Now they get it back to Braden McClung. And now it's to Hagee. Hagee's looking to work back to McClung. Drove for a second. Now McClung's going to spin in the lane. Gets a fadeaway jumper up and got it. So two more points for McClung.
Yeah, he gets those little jumpers like that. Short of fouling him, it's not really a lot you can do other than just try to play good defense and hope he misses.
And now into the lane is Dowdy, who's able to pick up a loose ball. Got knocked away from him as he drove in, but he picked it up and laid it in. And blocked by Ryan Cole, but the rebound comes out to Davis, and he doesn't get his shot to drop, and the rebound's brought out by Dowdy. Now it's to Ryan Mann over to Ryan Cole, and a three in the air, and can't get that one to go. Ryan Cole's had some open looks and just hasn't found the range. They're going to go into Baker now. Baker gets a man up, turns, shot, and got it.
Yeah, he's so good at that little sometimes it's almost a pure hook shot. Sometimes more like a jump hook. He's so effective at it. He just hasn't had luck with it tonight until that last possession there.
And a pass comes to McClung. He's going to pick up a screen from Davis, and now they'll just reset. Heggie with the ball now, guarded by Ryan Mann. And Heggie's going to drive by Mann and gets blocked at the hoop, but they're going to call the foul against Ryan Cole.
Yeah, they're more paying attention to that body contact there. Cole, even though he had position, once he went up, it kind of changes the referee's perspective.
Second foul on Ryan Cole. Shots on the way and gets the roll.
You see, man, they're guiding. He knows with foul situation he's in, and the fact that he's just not quite as quick on his feet. When he went by him, he didn't reach out and hold as he drops the second free throw, bringing your score to 33-31. James Rowe up by two. Second time out there, more concentrated on my chili dog than it was the game, and I didn't see who called the timeout.
33-31, just a 2-point game. James Monroe will have the ball when we get back. I think James Monroe had called that timeout.
We'll see first press from West thus far in the game tonight. Right before the end of the first half, they called that 30-second timeout to set that press up. Weren't able to do so because it's been too long in the huddle.
And ball's going to make it out of bounds.
It's two, hey.
It's Ryan Cole. He gets the ball over to Dowdy, and you're going to get a travel violation as he starts to drive. Be Cavalier ball, 2-point game. Mavericks with a slight advantage. McClellan calls the offense, works to Heggie. Heggie guarded by Ryan Mann. Pass it back inside to AG. Now back to Dixon. Dixon three in the air and got it. So Dixon off the bench. You see him talking about ice water right there, and it gives the lead 33-34. And they get the ball to Ryan Cole in the corner. Mavericks trying to run this offense.
It's a good matchup there between him and 33 with the foul situation.
Ryan Cole's going to have an open three. So he gets Dixon in the air. Instead, he's going to pass it up. The feed inside to Ridgeway. Ridgeway gets a couple defenders in the air and goes up and draws the foul. He'll be heading to the line. I thought Ryan Cole was going to launch on that three he had, but it
– Well, I'm glad he didn't.
Yeah, it closed out pretty quickly.
Yeah. And then Cooper, all that focus on him allowed Ridgeway just to kind of come down there and – set up camp.
That is the fourth foul on Colton Dunbar.
And, Ridgeway's been pretty quiet tonight, but he drops one from free throw line as you'd expect.
Chris Davis will come back into this game and relieve Colton Dunbar, who four fouls with 3 minutes to play in the third quarter. Not what you're wanting if you're Coach Roberts.
Second free throw gives James Rowe a 1-point lead.
Shot in the air and can't get it to go. Rebound, batted around, finally controlled by Ridgeway. Ridgeway's going to drive, gets the ball to Ryan Cole, now into Brady Baker. Baker finds Dowdy, to swings to Mann, three in the air, and it's short. And there's going to be some contact. The foul's going to go against Brady Baker.
Yeah, chasing the ball down there. The James Rowe just looked a little bit hectic and out of control in that whole possession. All for moving the ball around really fast, but that was just not sloppy. It was just hectic, frenetic, and a little bit out of control. That's the end of my adjectives I can come up with.
Heggie with the ball, working to McClung. McClung drives baseline, gets some contact against Ridgeway, and puts the shot in.
Fortune, no call there.
So two more points
there. They're back on the press. They haven't had success with it the first time they ran it, but a little bit better with it this time.
And they've broken it across half court. Get it back to Dowdy. Oh, and a backcourt violation. That was close, but they say he caught it just to that side. And it'll be a turnover.
He knew he was. He was trying to get, he's trying to get up in the air so he wouldn't be caught feet down in the backcourt. But
high pass comes in to Tanner Heggie, and he's able to control it, and he will work the Cavalier offense with a one-point lead. Into the lane as Dixon spins, gets a shot up from the baseline, can't get it to go. Rebound brought down by Ryan Cole. Goes to Cooper Ridgeway. Ridgeway's going to cut a couple of defenders. Gets it to Ryan Mann. Mann mishandles the pass but gets it back, but he's trapped in the corner.
That's a good opportunity for Chandler to slow down.
Yeah, works his way back and loses the handle again, but luckily Dowdy's there to clean it up. Dowdy's going to work against Tanner Heggie. Comes back to Cooper Ridgeway. Ridgeway gets a pass over to Cole. Three in the air for Cole. Off the back iron, no good, but a rebound brought down by Brady Baker, and he puts it back for two.
Yeah, that's where it's a foul situation that Wes is in. They're going to pay a penalty for that when they're on the defensive side in terms of rebounds. So
McClung gets a shot up and got it. That guy is just absolutely on a tear tonight. That is his 25th point.
Yeah, he's got the rest of the team's bus, the cheerleaders, everything on his back right now, and long, he's carrying them.
Long pass over to Dowdy. They get to – or Dunbar. They get to – no, sorry, Dunbar. To Ridgeway, who goes to Dowdy. Back to Ridgeway. Ridgeway drives and gets a layup to spin in and takes a one-point lead back with 45 seconds to play in the third quarter.
Yeah, we didn't see much out of Ridgeway in the first half, and that may be a, part of the reason why they went down with the locker room behind. But here in the second half, he's definitely making his presence felt.
Tanner Heggie has the ball. He's going to drive foul line and now gets it out to Dixon. Dixon back to Heggie. Heggie finds McClung. McClung's going to drive. He's cut off by Ridgeway. Back into the lane to Agee. Agee in some trouble as the ball's floated around. But it's going to end up with Braden McClung. McClung's going to drive and feeds a pass back out to Heggie, but it's taken away by Ryan Cole. Cole's going to drive in and a layup and good. And with 10 seconds to go, the Mavericks have taken a three-point lead.
That's how you can defend against Heggie and McClung is just not let him get the ball.
McClung has 2 seconds. He gets a shot and is fouled and makes it. And he can't miss. 27
points. Is there anybody else on the bench or on the court for either team that could have done that?
That was incredible. Got up in the air, made the shot, drew the foul, and has a chance to tie this thing going into the third quarter. Braden McClung.
Referee's right. He's making the not allowing him to get a free extra minutes here in the quarter break. Making
all the players come back on. Yeah. And Coach Robertson is going to sub in his entire bench there except for the shooter, and James Monroe is going to leave their guys out there.
That's
looks
a
like.
Smart little bit of coaching there from West.
Pretty good move.
A lot of people won't agree with what the official did there, but that's absolutely proper. It's absolutely proper.
Yeah, there's actually 0.8 seconds left on the clock. You wouldn't want to draw a foul here or something like that. Shot's going to be on the way, and he got it. That's going to tie the game. And a long pass into Cole. He fires a shot that hits the backboard but won't go. So James Monroe actually outscores the Cavaliers in the third quarter, but things end up tied 41-41. We're going to be back with the fourth quarter and who knows how much more basketball after that right after this.
We back.
We are back. A little extended break there as the 50-50 was read off.
The non-official stats. That's Braden McClung with two-thirds of the offensive production from Greenbrier West tonight.
Yeah, Braden McClung with 28 points so far. The next high scorer for that team is Tanner Hagee, who has six.
You know, he's been well defended. He's been left alone. He's been fouled. He's everything. And he's just unstoppable. Just unstoppable. See,
that ball works up top. That is Levi Ramsey. Comes back to McClung. McClung guarded by Ryan Mann, who has a tough assignment.
Chris
Hagee, they get it back to McClung. McClung
and double team finally.
And now back up top to Davis. Pass, shot can't go, rebound by McClung. He's going to get up to the basket, get it in. That's his 30th
Probably
point.
Probably the smallest man on the court.
That gives the Cavaliers back a two-point lead, 41-43. Dowdy's going to drive. He gets a shot up. And
oh, my goodness.
There's some ridiculousness on both sides of the court right now with getting this English off the backboard.
Yeah, that's exactly what I was going to say. He looks like he's out there playing snooker.
Now McClung comes to Davis. Davis finds Hagee. Hagee's going to push up a three off back iron. No. Rebound brought down by Ridgeway. Tie game as they get it up to Mann on the long pass. Mann's going to drive mid-range jumper offline. Rebound to Brady Baker. Baker's going to muscle his way into position. Can't get the shot to go. And Ryan Cole gets it. Put a shot up directly underneath the backboard.
Hit the bottom of the backboard, but it's picked up the foul.
Yeah. So that's going to send Ryan Cole to the line. I don't know if that was luck or if he knew he was about to get hit and wanted to get a shot off. That foul's going to be the first on Ramsey, and the free throw is the in and out.
The defense kind of fell off of Brady over there towards him. I think he knew their bodies were coming at him, maybe not so well in control of their hands and arms.
Shot on the way, got it to go. It's a one-point lead back to James Monroe.
Yeah, and he has struggled mightily offensively tonight. It's just uncharacteristic of him.
Yeah, and Hagee with a mid-range jumper up, leaves it short. Rebound brought out by Mann, but loses it off his foot, goes to Davis, and a block is going to be called. Foul on Ridgeway, yep. And that's going to be on the shot. We'll send Chris Davis to the line.
Looked pretty clean. If anything, if there was any skin-on-skin contact there, it was definitely the heel of his hand back towards his wrist area. Because he definitely got some.
Shot up and can't get the first one, so a chance to tie here. That's just the second foul on Ridgeway.
I've seen Davis. He'll probably drop this first one. I've watched some of his short jump shots and whatnot, and he's got a good-looking form, but there's something off with his shots because he just doesn't have much touch.
And like you said, buries it.
And here they are pressing again.
And a long pass.
And that was just not the pass to make. Not the pass to make.
They're going to get it in the hands of Hagee. Tie game right now, 44 all. It's a long two-pointer and misses, brought down by Dowdy. Yeah, he had his foot right on the line, and you saw the trailing official hold up two fingers. Ryan Mann has a three in the air, in and out, rebound by Brady Baker. He gets a shot up and gets it to go somehow. Brady Baker been a big part of this game right so far. He's got 11 points tied.
With the luck James Rose having, I'm just not a big fan of these long-range
offensive foul. Is that going to be on Braden McClung?
I'd love to see a replay of that.
I was not looking at the place where the foul was called.
I wasn't either.
That is going to be on McClung.
That would be his third.
It's going to be right down here. You see just a push off is what it was.
Oh, yeah, yeah. See it there now.
Yeah. So right in front of the official. And as points on this end. Who got those?
Ryan Mann.
Ryan Mann found the points.
He finally found the bottom of the basket.
But that is still only the third foul from McClung. Remember, that third one got changed over to Chris Davis
earlier. That's
right.
That's right, yeah.
So no real foul trouble for him here in the fourth quarter. And that ball stripped away. And that's Will Baugus on the court. He had a pretty big impact earlier and knocked out of bounds by McClung. It'll stay with James Monroe.
Yeah, I'm kind of fortunate. I kind of feel glad that it did get knocked out of bounds because it's going to force James Red actually set up and run their offense and take a high percentage shot, we would hope. As they spread the court out wide.
And that is to Dowdy in the corner, leaves it short, and the rebound brought out by Ramsey.
I'm not going to say anything about high percentage shots.
McClung skips through and can't get it to go. He ends up on the floor, and the ball ends up with Cooper Ridgeway. He's going to drive in, gets to Will Baugus. Baugus is going to back out, and will set the offense up from the top of the key. Works against Hagee, takes a jab step, drives to Dowdy in the corner. Dowdy is going to come out, trying to get it inside. Instead, goes all the way across to Baugus. Three in the air for Baugus. Bounce, bounce, miss, and it's brought down by Dunbar.
They spread the court out. They can flash and cut to the middle and get a high percentage shot, a little layup or cut and layup or whatever.
Foul on the floor. Will Baugus against Braden McClung, and fouled it. Braden McClung was driving to that spot where he's hit about 17 jump shots so far in this game, so maybe a foul was your best defense. And that would be AG to throw in, and he gets it into Hagee. Hagee's going to get a screen from Dunbar, who has to be careful playing with four fouls. Back to the top to McClung, and they trail by four with 4:17 ticking on the clock. McClung gets a jump shot up from the right side and got it. He can't miss from right there.
Yeah, they're wanting to spread the court out, get isolation one-on-one, let McClung take it to the basket.
Now Ridgeway is going to drive, takes it into the lane, feeds outside to Dowdy. Dowdy is double-teamed. And a dangerous pass, but it gets to Mann. Mann's going to push up this three straight away. Too hard. Can't get it to go, and it's tipped away and ends up on the floor, knocked out of bounds. They'll
and
say last touch.
It's going to be back to James Monroe.
Yeah, it looked like it came right off of McClung's
kind of rolled
ankle.
Off. It was first initially touched by one James Monroe player, sent it in that direction, and as it rolled towards the out-of-bounds line, it rolled right over McClung as he was prostrate on the floor.
A two-point game here with under 4 minutes to play. James Monroe would be well advised to slow this offense down as much
and
as possible.
Spread it out here, just as per usual. And now they need to start setting some picks and screens up top.
Dowdy with a three. Got it!
And just as I say that, they drop a three-pointer. But thus far in the game, you know, that shot hasn't been there for anybody on the James Monroe team.
And that's going to bring the crowd to their feet and draw a timeout from Coach Robertson. As the Mavericks have taken a five-point lead. He wants 30 seconds here to talk about this. So you have about 3.5 minutes to play, and you've just gone down five. What are you telling them in this huddle?
As far as James Monroe, all of a sudden it's a possession ball game now. You know, this is no different than eating time off the clock on a football field. There's no shot clock here. Hold the ball. Pass the ball. Stay away from risky cross-court passes. Go back to the weave and the old handoff. You know, we've seen them do in the past these situations. Make them foul you.
Your coach Robertson, what's your answer to that?
Aggressive, deny the passing lanes. Make them. You know, if James Rose is going to make those risky cross court passes, you know, make them pay.
And then get the ball in the hands of Braden McClung.
And yeah. And tell everybody else to get out of his way.
And that's what they've done right here. They've got it to McClung, and he's going to bring it over the center circle as the clock ticks under 3.5 minutes.
He's about a 5'10 version of Larry Bird.
Hands off to Hagee. Hagee in some trouble, and you're going to get a jump ball. Ryan Mann got a hand supinated at Ian. That arrow is going to point to James Monroe.
Yeah, they do have possession. Yeah, he kind of got the hand trapped.
Yeah, he
in
reached
there.
In as Hagee turned, and his hand was just trapped in there. Hagee may have trapped it against the ball. It got the jump ball call. Now the ball comes over to Ridgeway. Ridgeway is going to feed a pass all the way across to Will Baugus. And if you're James Monroe, like you said, you're just wanting to take as long of a possession here as you can. The clock's ticking down right to 180 seconds. And feed in to Mann. Mann's going to go back out to Baugus. Wide open three in the air, too strong. And that rebound knocked out of bounds. And they'll say last touch, James Monroe. It was hard for me to see.
Yeah, I couldn't see either.
Yeah, it was shielded. And the official was right on top of it. But I was shielded out by, I believe, Colton Dunbar. Hagee comes. He goes to McClung. McClung driving into that spot to the right side. Gets the shot up. No good, but a foul.
Yeah, he is.
see who this foul's going to go against. It's going to be Will Baugus.
Yeah, he was playing really good defense, hand up in the face. It just contact was created there.
Shot on the way, got it. Second shot up and good as well.
I'm not sure if you don't take McClung and double, or they'll come back with this. A press that's going to be pretty more aggressive this time than it has been in the past.
Yeah, they're going to back off as they get that ball back into the middle to Ridgeway.
And there we go.
Loses it over midcourt. They got McClung up front. He's going to back off, and the shot comes instead from AG, and he cashes in, makes it a one-point game again. And just like that, the timeout. And with 2.5 minutes to play, it's a one-point game. As an offensive foul on this side as Ridgeway drives right in.
2 minutes, 22 seconds left. You're sitting on a one-point lead. I understand you want the idea behind that, but you got if you're going to drive like that without numbers, you need to be.
McClung has the ball now on the left side. Comes back to the top to Chris Davis. Now they go back to McClung after he lost his dribble. He just wanted to get it back to him. Now it goes to Davis again. Find Heggie here on the right side as he works against Dowdy. Drives in the lane, gets a shot up over top of an outstretched Brady Baker. Can't get it to go, but the rebound brought down.
There's going to, yeah.
And that's going to be an off. Oh, is that on Colton Dunbar?
It sure is.
And he has fouled out.
Essentially over the back.
Yeah,
more like
Dunbar,
around the side. But
Dunbar
but
was trying to get that foul, I think, to go against anybody else on the
court. Yeah,
right
he was
there.
Pointing.
But it's going to be called against him and called for him about midcourt.
Yeah. It was.
And we're going to get a timeout.
And the official, he was emphatic about it. And from his position, you know, how they split the court into thirds, he had a really good look at it because there were no bodies between him and, well, there may have been one or two, but, I mean, there's essentially nobody between him and the action there.
So now you've got.
We're going to get this replay here on the foul.
Yeah, we're going to be looking right. In this area, folks,
as he goes over shoulder, his left shoulder to man's right shoulder is where the contact is at coming down.
Let's play that back through. I think it comes right after this. I think you're going to get a push off that right arm. So if we can stop it right there, and you can see this arm here. I just want to see if that gets extended and that draws the call. Yep, and that's what it does.
Yeah, that's what, yeah.
Yeah, not a lot there, but you extend that arm and you're going to get that.
Well, and plus the thing that really drew the attention to it was man was already on his way down, mm-hmm. but the fact that he hit the floor really would make would really draw an official's attention to, well, why is he there?
So after that, it's an empty possession, a one-point deficit for the Cavaliers, and you've just lost Colton Dunbar. A minute 57 seconds remain as they inbound
the ball.
Nothing
unusual about the press there.
Yeah, Will Baugus works against Dixon. Damian Dixon hit that three-pointer early. It's playing large in this game right now. And ball works into Baker. Baker feeds back out to Ryan Mann. Mann drives in, jump stop, gets it out to Dowdy. Dowdy swings a pass back to the top to Ridgeway. Now to Will Baugus. He's trying to eat some clock here. And get a good look, I imagine. You still need some points. You can't just
put the ball down there. Get the ball down there to Brady Baker as he will get possession. Position.
Baugus drives in, goes back to Dowdy, comes back to Ridgeway, now to Mann.
As he flashes, and he's either going to get an easy little jump hook or whatever out of it, or he's going to wind up fouled.
Mann dribbles in, loses his dribble, and has to get it back to Ridgeway. I think they're playing keep away at this point. They've had the ball for almost 60 seconds. Going to get a screen here from Brady Baker. He's going to pick, he's going to roll. Jump cut
almost up and
Baugus.
Down there. Almost up and down there on behalf of Baugus. Real good to keep his feet on the floor.
Clock ticks down to a minute before Dixon will come out and give the foul. They still have
they
one, to,
one
give
to give
before they get in the bonus.
But I tell you something. Right now, Dean Smith, wherever, whatever headstone he's laying under, he's smiling.
And a timeout.
You have to be over
certain. Oh, no, they want Will Cole in the game is what. Will Cole. I did that again. Yeah. They want Ryan Cole into the game.
With that, the rebounding and also that interior position presence, I mean, to get that easy 2-point.
And Mavericks know when they can go into the backcourt. Inbound there to Dowdy, and he'll bring the ball over as he works against Heggie. They go to Ryan Mann. I don't think there's a green light to shoot right now. I think they're wanting to get that foul. Mann's going to drive. And timeout. So
and Coach Savage, as you see, the body language there from Coach is like, calm down, mm-hmm. slow it down. I think they were afraid that James Road players were wanting to bite so bad on that open lane and drive and try to shoot. They knew, Coach knows as soon as they do that, the defense is going to collapse on them and create a good opportunity to create a turnover.
Mm-hmm. 42 seconds on the clock. Braden McClung had 28 points through the third quarter, and he's added six more here, so he's sitting on 34.
Still sitting right real close to two-thirds of their total.
Announcement came over. It looks like the 50-50 that was Drew has been donated back. Scott Miller won that.
They've been taking a lesson from Caden there in political maneuvering.
Mm-hmm. 42.1 seconds. The point one could be big, folks. You just don't know. Ball comes into the backcourt to Dowdy. He works against Heggie as he drives in. Get clears midcourt. And Mavericks are going to play keep away. They have 33 seconds. The Cavaliers are almost going to have to foul. And they did. And it's going to go against
either Heggie or McClung. Not McClung.
Dixon, yeah. But it's going to send Cooper Ridgeway to the line. Ridgeway has two free throws in this game.
Yeah, that's he's had a really quiet offensive night, but he's good from the line. So,
got it. One's big, has a chance to make this a 3-point game.
Out of the folks on the court now for James Rowe, you want on the line. He's not it.
And second one goes. But being the guy you don't want to put on the line.
Right.
Yeah.
Last year, year before, maybe he is, but he's got a lot of basketball under his belt now.
And a timeout from Coach Robertson comes with 22.2 and a 3-point deficit. So we had this conversation a minute ago. What are you saying now? Are you looking for a three at this point to try to tie this up, or are you getting it in the hands of McClung, try to get the two and play out?
They got one timeout, 22 seconds. I say give it to McClung. Let him see if he can't draw a foul as he goes up. That gives you the opportunity, you know, if he gets the basket, that gives you the opportunity to tie the game up with the clock stopped.
Mm-hmm. Still too early, you think, to go for that three-pointer?
I think that he may be relying on their defensive ability to create a turnover within those 22 seconds, though, you know, he also has to back up and think, you know, he can't coach as he has throughout this whole game because he's missing one key cog in the machine.
Yeah, he doesn't have Colton Dunbar out there. He can still run his press. So the idea could be hit what you can and then try to get the turnover on the press, and if not, foul and see if they can hit two from the line and again.
James Rose Forger, they still sitting on two timeouts. So, you know, if they get in offensive trouble in terms of the press, in terms of a really bad trap situation, they can always take a timeout.
Now, this is interesting. Ryan Cole on the bench as we come back out. Will Bogus back in the game.
You want your superior ball handler out there, and or at least that's my mind.
Pass into the backcourt goes to McClung. 20 seconds tick away.
Yeah, they're going to just run their offense here, try to get isolation on McClung one on one,
and going to get a foul. That's a foul they can give though, and they can't actually. That's going to be into the bonus. That's their fifth. So, to the line, maybe not the worst thing you could have had happen if you're James Monroe. And now Ryan Cole's going to get back up and go in for that off. I think they just had Will Bogus in for
maybe
that
out there just to give that foul to stop the drive, though. I'm not really sure why we do that whenever you're in the bonus.
The way he reacted, that's going to actually foul him out. And, wow, in and out. He had not missed a free throw this half, I believe.
He's not missed anything except for one shot he took from flat on his back, I don't think.
Shot on the way and got that one.
And straight into that press. So James Rudy needs to remember they.
And it goes into man, and they'll foul man immediately.
Yeah, and I'll tell you what, that was not, that foul was not supposed to happen.
No, I don't think so. They
was going for strictly
the steal.
Going for the ball. And probably a pretty wise, you know, if you're going to.
Yeah, I mean, if he hadn't got the foul right there and
he would have gotten
steal,
the turnover. Or
if he hadn't got the steal and the foul didn't happen, they would have run 10 seconds off the clock before anybody could have got back to him. And a miss on the first shot.
Yeah, just barely made contact with the rim.
So this is a big one where it could give the Mavericks a 3-point lead. And it's up and can't get it to go. Rebound's going to be brought down by Agee. And it comes back out to Dixon. Dixon feeds to McClung. McClung's going to drive against Baker. Goes up, shot up, and good. Tie game, 4 seconds to go. It's in the hands of Mann. He's going to throw full court. And I heard a whistle during that.
I indicated a timeout, but why did James? Why did they not call timeout with 5 seconds left and try to set up something?
I think that's what, and we're going to get a turnover. Savage is saying that he called this timeout, I think, before the ball was inbounded. He's emphatic, but.
Well, to me, I couldn't understand why they didn't. And to me, it seemed like, you know, I couldn't understand why they didn't. And it seemed like mass confusion down here in terms of James Ray thinking, we can see on the replay here, maybe we could catch Coach, maybe we can catch some sort of indication of the timeout if we back it up to the shot being made. That he was jumping up and down.
Yeah.
He, as the camera comes across the half-court line, you can see Coach jumping up and down, I think indicating that he's wanting a timeout.
We have a timeout now.
And there would have been a timeout with perhaps, I don't know how, 5.3 seconds, maybe something close to that on the clock.
Yeah, if we can go back, I don't know how far we can go back and look to see when that ball went through. And you see he's trying to call the timeout there, and he's already to the point where he's jumping up and down trying to call it.
I think he was doing that when the camera panned from left to right initially and the shot went through. I think as it was catching up to the action, I think you can see him over there next to the scorer's table jumping up and down, making hand and arm gestures as for timeout. So here we are, 2.5 seconds left on the clock. Probably about 2 seconds less than there should be.
They'll have an inbound here with a fair bit of time. And an offensive foul.
Oh, my goodness. And that offensive foul is going to be on Chris Davis as he fouls out.
And that's going to be 2.5 seconds out for the Mavericks. They're going to take a timeout.
So this, looking at this going into overtime,
Chris Davis is fouled out. Colton Dunbar is fouled out, and Will Baugus is fouled out for the Mavericks. If you don't end the game here, you're going to go in with those two down, you know, to a 5-minute overtime.
Unfortunately, if you're James Rowe, unfortunately, though, going into that overtime, McClung is still going to be on the floor.
With, I believe McClung has three fouls now, so he's in no real trouble.
No, not the way he plays. I mean, he's unless he just takes leave of his mental faculties there, he's not going to pick up a cheap foul. Didn't get to see that offensive foul really well. I just saw some contact.
Seconds before we get back into this. So Mavericks are going to have 2.5 seconds. That's well enough time to actually get the ball in and get a shot.
Nice. And James Rose is going to be inbounding the ball here with 2.5 seconds, and James Rose still sitting on one timeout.
And Dowdy needs to get the ball in.
To take that timeout. Yeah, Chance, what do you think? Boomer inbound the pass. I mean, inbound the ball, make one pass after the inbound play, get somewhere down on your side of the court. And get off some sort of a shot.
Yeah, first thing you have to make sure you do is get the ball inbounded. So I think I would have somebody, Ryan Cole or Brady Baker, somebody to run back if in case you need it. You can just lob a pass that he can go up and catch come down.
Yeah, they needed some.
Get the time to expire.
They needed some help there coming back to the ball for that inbound play.
So now we're going to have a different look as all five Mavericks are going to be in the backcourt. And they'll have a cutting Ridgeway. Trying to go full court. They go to Ryan Mann. He gets his hands on a turn. Shot in the air and can't make it. Oh, and Brady Baker was underneath trying to get the lob back up but doesn't. Folks, hey, you got some free basketball coming to you tonight. We're going to have actually 4 minutes of an overtime. For at least the first round of it, and we'll just take the break with the teams and be right back. Don't go anywhere. Why would you?
Wow.
Reno Medical Center is located in the heart of Reno and has provided quality health care to our community for over 45 years. We offer medical, dental, pediatrics, pharmacy, behavioral health therapy, x-ray, mammography, diabetes education, and on-site lab services. We accept most insurance plans and offer a sliding fee scale for qualifying patients. Make us your family's medical home and let us care for you. Reno Medical Center. Excellent health care right at home.
All right, so we're going to pretend we're playing a new game. We're going to have 4 minutes here. We're going to jump from the center circle.
Yeah, but Davis gets up, and James Rowe completes the tip.
Yeah, and Cole goes up and gets that, but mainly because the guy he jumped against in the beginning is sitting on the bench with five fouls now, and Ryan Cole gets a shot from the sideline. Can't get a sideline from the corner. That's rebounded out by Mann, gives it to Dowdy, and we're going to get a travel as he took a little hop.
Now, Layton, it's so hard to control when you see something you want to do so bad.
Yeah, we see it every game multiple times.
Yeah.
Boys, girls, doesn't matter what teams we're seeing. We see that call multiple times a game. Now, Dixon gets the ball over to Ramsey. Ramsey finds McClung. McClung's going to drive to the right side, spins, gets into Ryan Mann, no call, and just misses off the front of the rim. Rebound brought out by the Mavericks. They get it over to Ridgeway. Ridgeway comes back to Mann. Mann to Dowdy in the corner. Hit a three from there earlier, but now we'll just get the ball back to the top to Dowdy. Ridgeway, sorry. Now back to Dowdy. Dowdy finds Ridgeway.
They were waiting on.
Baker turns, fights through, gets a shot up, can't get it to go, gets his own rebound, gets another one up, can't get it to go. Rebound brought down by Agee. Had two good looks.
And that's what they were waiting on. That's what they were looking for the entire time.
Now McClung has the ball on the right side. He's going to take his time as he works back to Heggie. Heggie to McClung.
McClung's gotten tied up there.
Heggie's going to run baseline as McClung drives, gets a shot up, and can't get that one to go. Rebound by Baker. Baker hassled. Now he's going to dribble out and get it to Dowdy.
McClung may feel just too much responsibility as resulting in those I tell you, do the same thing you did last time. Look for Mann or Baker.
Into Mann now. Mann's going to get a shot from straightaway. In and out. Can't get it. Rebound by Ridgeway. Ridgeway gets a shot up.
And one.
And the foul. 2:07 to play. Mavericks take a two-point lead here in overtime, and they'll have a chance from the line to make it a three-point game.
I tell you, Cooper's not been as well. I tell you,
he's added up. He's got three in the first half, four in the second half, and he's just got two more.
And he gets the roll on the three-point on the old-fashioned three-point play. Gives James Rowe a three-point lead with 2 minutes 6 seconds left.
Actually, he had six. Now he's got three.
They've been timely. He's very timely offensive and defensive plays tonight. We'll say that.
To McClung. McClung holds the ball with a minute 50 seconds to play, and he's going to be double-teamed by Baker and Mann. They get it over to A.G. A.G. in and up and can't get the shot to go, but a rebound brought down by McClung.
Guess who, yeah.
And McClung gets it out of the crowd, drives back in, and we're going to get a foul. I think that's going to go against Brady Baker. Mavericks wanted an offensive foul. I think Baker was moving, so little. Only the second foul.
He's given. He's you know, McClung's given up a lot of size. Baker's given up a lot of speed. And in that particular situation, size is less important than the speed is.
The foul shot's coming with a minute 38, and first one's good.
And I still say when we get back on the offensive end, I still say punch the ball in there to Baker. You know, he had those two good looks. It wasn't like a touch, wasn't like a position, wasn't like his ability to make that shot. It was just bad luck.
And makes a second. The Mavericks
and now we see his
having trouble getting this ball, and a foul on McClung.
Oh, my goodness.
That'd be number four. Now, if he fouls out of this game, that changes
that's
the entire
a whole different
complexion. He has to be ultra careful now with that fourth foul.
Yeah, just a cheap little reach in with.
This will send Ryan Mann to the line. He missed his two at the end of regulation and gets that one.
Yeah, Ryan has played up to par defensively tonight. His touch seemed to be a little bit off offensively tonight. Of course, you can say that about.
Second one on the way. Got it, so no problem with those. Gives the Mavericks that three-point lead back in a minute and 30 seconds to play as the ball comes to Heggie.
And he's travel. Same exact thing as with Layton down there. Just he saw that.
You know, I've noticed the several defensive possessions, and they get the ball on these wings. The Maverick defense is setting up, leaving the inside open. That's the way they want him to go. They're trying to funnel. Now, the thing is, McClung has got down there and made him pay for it, but it's still they're wanting to push that ball down there and work that double team.
Yeah, once you get down there low, they'll collapse on you.
Now the ball to Ridgeway. Ridgeway gets it to Baker. Baker's wide open and scores!
Yeah. I saw him down there, and it looked like he had ants in his feet. He was just
McClung with the jump shot. Leaves it short. Rebound brought out to Ryan Cole. Cole hugs the ball.
Now, a minute 6 seconds left. You just need to slow down. Slow down. You're sitting on a five-point lead.
And now the ball to Dowdy. Dowdy comes back to the top of the key to Ridgeway.
It's exactly what I wanted to see out of him right now. Spread the court out.
And the Mavericks with 45 seconds to play are back into a keep-away mode. And it's McClung. He can't foul.
No, and he almost did there.
Yeah, he can't give the foul or he would foul out.
And now we see it looks like we're in the.
Now Mann has the ball, gets it over to Ridgeway. They have let half.
There's the foul.
And that's McClung. They should have. Anybody else should have given that foul at any
point.
I'll
tell you what,
you can tell
from his body language right there, it was just total frustration on his behalf.
Yeah, there were opportunities for that foul to be given, but they never were. And now McClung, forced to give it, has fouled out of the game.
I tell you, it looked like shades of. Late 70s, early 80s, Carmichael Auditorium, North Carolina and Duke.
Folks, this is another just instant classic from these two teams. It happens so often. Shot on the way, no good. And they're going to pull the entire Maverick team
back. Yeah, put everybody back in.
Actually, they're going to put the two guards in to rebound and send the forwards and the center back. And the second one goes.
A little token pressure on the inbounds play to try to slow them down.
And it'll be Heggie. As he doesn't have McClung.
We have Aiden Crane in the game. I just set that pick.
Long two. Got it. And I think he thought that was a three, but his midsole of his foot had got onto the line.
Yeah. Well, he had – the way the screen was set up, it didn't permit him to be back behind the arc whenever, you know, the screen was going to be effective. I don't know if I mentioned that. It's Aiden Crane, number 14 in the game, I think, first time tonight.
Yeah. He's fat out of the game, but I want to just go back to this. Braden McClung ends the night with 38 points.
And so do the math there, 57 total offensive production from Greenbrier West tonight.
I cannot remember in the years we've been doing this a player who's come into this gym and been able to put on that kind of performance. I don't think you can say enough tonight about what Braden McClung came in and what he – as bad as he wanted this and what he was able to do here tonight.
Absolutely not. He's outperformed everybody else on his team. He's outperformed James Murray's defense. He's done everything except go over there and lead the cheerleading squad and keep the time.
Yeah, Braden McClung.
I tell you what, you're not gonna find
many players better than Braden.
The all around. It's not just offense. It's not just okay. Set up, take 3-point shots. It's not fast breaks. It's not leading the offense. If it's offense, defense, you see him go down there amongst trees and somehow or another battle around and come out with the ball. I don't know how many offensive or defense. I don't know what his rebound totals are tonight, but it has to be over a half a dozen.
Yeah. Yeah. If you're a scout watching this game, hopefully you've seen Braden.
And in basketball intelligence, too. Other than that last foul, I mean, his ability to always make the proper decision is just...
The decision he made there was right. He was just forced
into it. Yeah.
And there's a foul given to Ridgeway. He'll head to the line, 10.7 left. If he can make one of these, it's basically put the game...
Yeah, it turns into a three-possession ball game. Two-possession ball game. Makes both of them three-possession. It makes both of them two-possession ball game. I'm sorry. Coach Walker, wherever you are...
Yeah, misses the first.
I still can't do math.
Still, even if it misses both, it's a 4-point game. Still a difficult road to climb with 10 seconds left. Second shot's on the way and got it. So it's a 5-point game now.
And just do not foul.
And Hagee drives in. He's going to take it in, hooking to get some contact.
That was a little soft touch there. Yeah, he tried his best to draw contact.
Doesn't have to inbound. There's not enough time. And that's going to do it. The Mavericks give it up. That's a pretty basketball smart play right there to realize you have enough time ticking off the clock or you don't have to inbound.
Barn burner. Just get the barn burner trophy for the industrial games I've seen this year, both watching live and on YouTube.
You know, every time we get a schedule, I circle the games, James Monroe and Greenbrier West, because you know it's going to be this kind of game.
Yeah, and
you can't say enough about what West came in here into a difficult place to play and was able, the game they were able to give James Monroe, and you can't give enough about James Monroe. And
guess what? February 15th. James Monroe travels to Raynell. Did you catch that? February 15th. We get to do it all again at their house. And don't you think they are not going to be motivated?
That's right. I mean,
That might 15th. Be worth the trip up there.
Yeah, that'll almost certainly be a game that will be broadcast. And if we can make it happen, we will. But tonight, James Monroe edges out Greenbrier West in overtime. And a 38-point performance by Braden McClung.
And on February 15th, Jamie don't have to work, so I know where he's going to be.
We're going to take a break. Be right back with stats and postgame.
All right, folks, we're here after this barn burner, 62-59 overtime victory by James Monroe. Able to edge this one out back and forth all night. We got Brady Baker and Cooper Ridgeway here. Point-wise, Brady, looks like you had 13. Cooper, you had 14. You two spread it out pretty good today. Hey, just walk me through that whole game right there. Just what was your mindsets coming in and how did it go, change as you played out?
Well, we came in here, we couldn't hit nothing. Couldn't hit the bronze side of the board the first two quarters, and we just stuck with it and tried to get to the rim. I mean, even when we did that, we couldn't make it, but we stepped up our defense, tried to play a little bit faster and get easier buckets, and I think it's what we did.
Yeah, you know, when you play West, it's going to be like that. It don't matter what you're playing. I mean, it's going to be a battle, and it comes down to things like rebound and hustle plays and stuff like that. And even though we didn't shoot well tonight, we did well in that aspect, so it helped us get the win.
You guys able to pull it away in the end. Braden McClung came in, and I had him at 38 points for this game. He was able to penetrate and pretty much just hit every shot he put up. What was he like on the court tonight and guarding him? What were y'all guys trying to do with him?
Yeah, he was tough. You said it right. He was hitting everything he threw up. It didn't matter what angle he was coming up, where he was at, it was going in the night, and we just did the best that we could to contain him, and it turned out it was enough in the end.
Yeah, I mean, he's a heck of a player. Just getting to the basket, drawing fouls. This big guy's hard to come over and help on him because you're afraid to get in foul trouble, so it's hard to guard him.
What did Coach Savage say to you guys as it went into overtime?
He just told us it's a brand-new game, 0-0. It's first quarter, to lock in and just restart and play better.
Yeah, I mean, he just told us it's a brand-new game. Start over. Let's fix our mistakes and win it.
Brady, you had a big score right there in that overtime. Tell me about that. How did you get so open down there?
I kind of learned Cameron Thomas in the past. He just floated around and got open a lot, so I kind of learned from him just to float around. The defense will lose you sometimes, and that just happened right there. That's what happened.
Yeah, was that a dance you were doing down there when you were sitting there wide open? Like, are you trying to do some sort of Jedi mind trick to get the ball down there?
I give these guys a hard time, but they do a pretty good job of getting me the ball. But I was a little excited, and I had a chance to score and put it away. So,
One thing I want to mention to you, this is only the second game I've got to watch you guys on this year, work and whatnot. That little jump hook that you developed.
Oh, yeah.
It's a killer, is it not? It's your size. All you've got to do is just get positioned and –
Well, I mean, yeah, I'm a bigger guy. I can't jump out the gym or anything, so I got to find ways to get it off like that. Coach Lust last year helped me develop that a lot. So.
Exactly. Well said in the ball call game. I said, you're not the fastest guy, and you don't have a doggone 30-inch vertical leap. You know, play that position game, and good soft touch. And even just, y'all touched on it earlier, the field goal percentage towards the last third of the first half, it was, y'all admit, it was atrocious. But to see, you know, everybody stayed with, one thing I want to compliment y'all on, and I've got to go. Y'all stayed within your game. A couple of jump hooks you had down there just bobbled around and fell right out. And the fact you went right back down and kept doing it again. I think you picked up 4 points there, critical points for his last part of the game. And Cooper, you were quiet in the first half. I kept asking, you know, what's up with him? But you had timely plays. You scored whenever you needed. You showed up offensively. You made those assists when they needed to be made. And I think that just shows from the maturity level you guys played together a long time now, and that reflects in these close games. And I get to go up and talk absolute BS to my colleagues tonight, who some of them are from Raynell. So one thing I wanted to mention, you guys have to go back to West here in about 2 weeks. You know they're going to be they're going to be sitting on. This is going to cause them heartburn between now and then. So I'm sure you guys are not going to go in there sleep at the switch. With that, congratulations, a great game. I'll see you guys later.
Thank you.
You know, we talked to Coach Savage right before, and Cooper, he brought up you as being somebody who was a leader on this team this year. You knew you had to be coming in. He said, you know, you lead by example, and you know it's easy to lead when things are going really well, but on a night like this, what do you have to do to step up to change that?
I just got
to
bring us all together. And like he said, I just told him we got to keep playing our game and shots will start falling. Whether they did or not tonight, we found a way to get the win, and that's all that matters.
Hey, you guys don't have anything easier the rest of the week. You got Summers County, I think, coming in tomorrow and then Greater Beckley on Friday. So what's the rest of your week look like? You don't have much time for preparation. You just got to be up and go. What do you do in weeks like this?
You just got to take it one day at a time, one game at a time, and one quarter at a time, and just get out with as many wins as you can.
Yeah, I mean, like Cooper said, it's just one play at a time, and come out and get wins. It's going to be a tough stretch, but you got to just keep working, and work it all out.
All right, that's going to do it for here. Anything you guys want to say before we get out?
I'm good.
Hey, James Monroe, an instant classic, 62-59 in overtime against Greenbrier West. Probably the biggest single-A game in the state tonight. A lot of eyes on it, and we're glad we're able to bring it to you. We'll be back tomorrow night. Summers County coming into town. We'll see you then.
Thank you.
The next time you find yourself stuck, broken down, or stranded, call Steve's Towing. Serving eastern and western Greenbrier counties and surrounding areas, he won't charge an arm and a leg. All he wants is a tow. Providing rollback service for light and medium duty vehicles, as well as lockout service and jump starts. Call 304-661-5255. Steve Fields, owner and operator.
Western Auto in Raynell is the solution for all of your automotive repair needs. We carry snow blowers, wood splitters, propane heaters, and a full line of Husqvarna saws, bars, and chains. And most importantly, service after the sale. We also carry Whirlpool washers and dryers, freezers, refrigerators, and hot water heaters. We have enjoyed serving our community for 48 years and support our Greenbrier West Cavaliers.
Reno Medical Center is located in the heart of Reno and has provided quality health care to our community for over 45 years. We offer medical, dental, pediatrics, pharmacy, behavioral health therapy, x-ray, mammography, diabetes education, and on-site lab services. We accept most insurance plans and offer a sliding fee scale for qualifying patients. Make us your family's medical home and let us care for you. Reno Medical Center. Excellent healthcare right at home.